This episode was brought to you by the number 42. Hello, everybody. Welcome back. My name is John Fillmore, and welcome to another episode of The Pokemon Analyst. Last time, I gave you a bit of an introduction of what's going to be happening throughout the summer and things like that, and today, we're going to actually be starting with team building. Now, before I start, something to keep in your back of your head. I'm going to be working with doubles. Right? And that's important because singles, doubles, triples, rotation, they all require a different mindset of how to play, right? And what do I mean with that is, okay, let's say you were to make a team for a singles, yeah? Okay, you make it, it works fine, and then you say, you know what, let's go to doubles. Well, unless your team is incredibly well organized and things like that, it has less chance to win, I think, than any team that actually is built specifically for doubles, right? Because you need a completely different strategy, a completely different mindset, all that good stuff. So it's important to keep in mind for which tier you're playing with. So we're going to be doing doubles. Now, to start a team, most experts say start with a core. And I say, yes, start with a core. And what is a core? Well, that could be anything from an idea, a strategy, a Pokemon, and that Pokemon could be your favorite Pokemon, your least favorite Pokemon, a Mega Evolution, anything like that, you know, something which you can build your team around. Now, to choose a core, that really depends on you, right? Because, first of all, I can't choose a core for you, and second, your core is really your heart of your team. This is what decides what it is, right? Because there are plenty of teams out there. You can look up online and you get, you know, plenty of teams and things like that. But what makes your team your team? What makes it different? And I think that's the core. Of course, that's also from what else you put in it, but it's very important to see, okay, why do I choose this core? What do I like it? What do I not like about it? All that fun stuff. Now, the thing is, you need to choose your core, but you need to also choose your core because you want to, not because you need to, right? Mega Kangaskhan is a very solid Mega Evolution. However, it's used a lot. And if you say, you know what, I don't really want to use it because it's very, very common, and I want to use something different, you know what, you do that. You know, there are over 700 Pokemon out there, 721 to be exact. Okay, Volcanion hasn't been released yet, or at least hasn't up to today. But the thing is, there are over 700, and that means you can do anything with your team. Unless your core is something like a level 1 Magikarp that only has Splash, or like a level 5 Sunkern, you can do whatever you want. If you find something where you say, aha, it works, then you do that. Because that's the most important thing, I think. It's not the strategies and things like that. Okay, that comes second. First things first. You choose it because you want to. Alright? Now, I'm going to be working with a Mega Evolution core, right? Why is that? Well, first of all, it is quite common to actually use a Mega Evolution for your core. And second, it's a nice Pokemon, you know, I really enjoy it. So, we're going to be using that one. It's not my favorite, but it's a really good one. So, let's start. Okay, we have an empty slot here. Let's call this the Pokemon Analyst. There we go. Alright, then we'll add a Pokemon. Now, Gardevoir, you know what, I'm going to choose this one, because then you can still choose your abilities and things like that, so that can sometimes be quite handy. With a Gardevoir right, alright, and then I'll put Mega Gardevoir next to it, just to be able to refer back to it. Nope, it doesn't like that one. Here we go. Okay, and the item, of course, is a Gardevoir right, but you know what, we're going to delete this after we're done, just as a reference point. Now, the reason why I like Mega Gardevoir is pretty much one reason. Pixelate. Pixelate is an amazing ability. Why is that? Well, this Pokemon has a couple of normal moves. And with Pixelate, these normal moves first have a 1.3 boost in power, and then they become fairy types. Well, Gardevoir is a fairy type, so it gets a stab boost as well. So it gets the 1.5 boost from Pixelate, and then gets a 1.5 stab boost. So that's literally a 1.8 times. That's almost double. So that's really good. It's not the same as adaptability, but it's pretty good. And the real clincher is that it knows Hyper Voice. And Hyper Voice is amazing. Because Hyper Voice hits adjacent foes, 90 power, 100% accuracy, is a normal type, special, 16 PP. It's amazing. It's like it was built for Mega Gardevoir. Because if we look at the stats, right, 165 base special attack. That is insane, right? Special defense, also pretty good. Okay, sure, these are kind of lacking, but this is really what makes the clincher. With this, combined with Pixelate, it can be incredibly powerful. So, we're going to be activating this one. There we go. And now, what could make it even more deadlier if you're feeling really naughty? Add Calm Mind. Because then, you get a 1.5 boost in not only special attack, but also special defense. So it becomes a tank and a hard hitter. Okay, sure, you need to use a move, one turn for it. But if your partner is good enough, you have that ability. Now, as its last slot, I'm going to put in Protect. In singles, Protect isn't really that necessary, but in doubles and triples and things like that, you're going to need the Protect, right? That's pretty much a staple, right? So unless you have something like a a choice band or a choice scarf, or you really need the extra space, then, okay, don't go for the Protect, go with something else. But if you don't have anything like that, which I don't in this case, put the Protect. And now you get that last slot. Well, you could do things like Shadow Ball, right? You could do things like Thunderbolt. You could do things like, see if I can spell this right, Psychic. Psych Up works as well. A little rarer, but it works. You could use things like Energy Ball. You could use Dazzling Gleam. You could use Moonblast. There is a lot of potential for that last slot. I'm going to go with the Energy Ball, and I'll tell you why. Because Energy Ball is a grass type, right? And especially against, you know, bulky water types and, Wash Rotom and things like that, you really want that counter, right? And Energy Ball is a little less common than things like Shadow Ball or Psychic on a Gardevoir. People are like, oh, it's a Gardevoir. Oh, I better switch out my water type because otherwise it's going to hit me with an Energy Ball or a Thunder Wave or a Thunderbolt or something like that. No, people are going to be like, oh, shouldn't be that hard. I'll just keep it in. And then you can hit it with a Surprise Energy Ball, which, for me, is quite handy, especially against Rotom. Because that thing can wreck your halls if you're not prepared for it. So I'm putting that one in there. Now, as ability, I mean, you can't really choose the ability for Mega, but you can for its normal type. For its normal evolution, I suppose. Synchronize, you could use Trace. I don't really like it. It leaves it up to randomness and things like that. I'm going to put Telepathy, right? Because if I have something like, I don't know, an earthquake or something like that, that I'm shooting towards my opponent, I want to make sure that I don't get hit, because otherwise I'm going down, right? So let's look at some of these stats. Now, HP, measly. Attack, measly. Defense, measly. Special attack and special defense, pretty good. And especially during Mega Evolution, they get a pretty big boost. These are still pretty much the same Okay, they have a little bit of an increase, but you're not going to use this at all. This is kind of worthless. Your HP is doable. And your speed, okay, you're in the hundreds tier now, but... you know what? I want to make sure that he's just a tiny bit faster. So, we're going to bring this to level 50. Because all battles are done in level 50, if you did not know that. Because now you do. And it has 120 speed, and that's with full IVs. Well, you know what? I'm going to boost it up to 130. Okay, that's 80 EVs. So what could I do next? All right, I'm going to add 80 in here. All right. You could start to buff up the defense, right? But I'm gonna do something different. This thing is a monster, and I want to make it as monstrous as possible. So I'm gonna give it 252 EVs in special attack, right? That gives it, at level 50, 217 with, okay, full IVs and EVs, and that's not even with nature and things like that. 217. That's pretty good. That's gonna leave a dent. Right? And let's see, what else could you do? Well, the thing that is that's really its downfall, it's kind of frail. So you know what? I'm gonna add the rest. I'm gonna put those into HP. Now, for the last thing, I'm going to give it a modest nature. Why is that? Well, first of all, modest, you decrease the attack. Well, that's fine, because I wasn't going to use that anyway. And the special attack gets even more boosted, right? So if you have the opportunity, it is going to wreck everyone's day. And that is precisely what I'm looking for. So there you have it, guys. This is my core. This is what I'm going to be working with. This one can go bye-bye. And now it's time for the next Pokemon. But I'm going to leave that on a different day. Now, there are other ways, of course, of making a Gardevoir. I know that Verlus has done one or two videos about this. He's a really good guy. Go check it out. He does a lot of competitive stuff as well. Also, the Dex has done an episode on Gardevoir, and I'm pretty sure Mega Gardevoir was put in there as well. So give it a look if you need a little bit more inspiration for things like that. Thank you so much for watching. If you like it, please like, please subscribe. It really does help me. So if you want to do that, please do. Other than that, I do not really have anything else to report. So this is John Fillmore signing off and wishing everyone on the opposite side of the screen a very pleasant day. Goodbye.